A high-level delegation of experts meeting between IGAD and the Transitional Government of National Unity of South Sudan has kicked off today in Kampala. It is at this meeting that the free movement of persons, including workers, the recognition of academic papers across borders, coupled with the harmonization of labor laws and the rights of residents, will be discussed as the roadmap towards enabling the operationalization of the protocols.
That movement must take into consideration the challenges posed by wrong elements. How do we, in the arrangements, provide opportunities for easy movement, also control the movement of wrong elements?
But it has emerged that sections of the public in South Sudan are not comfortable with the proposed protocols. They fear that this will give an opportunity to foreigners to take up their jobs and exploit their resources, drawing from their experience with Sudan from which they seceded.
I call on the IGAD experts to address any questions, any concerns, and any queries that their South Sudanese counterparts might raise clearly. The government of South Sudan rely on its experts partaking in this meeting to carry out particular awareness across the country so that the people of South Sudan see the benefit of being part of the region or the continent. They must clearly see the difference between their long negative experience with Khartoum compared to IGAD and the African Union.
But against a background of the lowest level of intra-Africa trade standing at just 18%, as compared to that of Europe at 69, there is general consensus that the protocols on free movement should be adopted and ratified sooner than later. This, they say, will enable Africa grow its export volumes among its countries. Currently, Africa contributes only 2.4% of the global export volumes, further implying that Africa remains the least integrated of all world regions. The three-day consultative meeting has brought together top officials from IGAD, all ministries in the transitional government of South Sudan, and the European Union, which hopes that the protocols will reduce the dangerous journeys that Africans, especially from the region, make to that continent in search of what they call a better life. Lebege Emmanuel, reporting for Urban Television.